So, good morning, everyone. I am Ravi Asati, your trainer for campuses equipment training. And especially today, we are going to start with the first module of technical training, that is the first module of C. So, before starting the session, I would like to tell you about the outline of the session, because in this particular session, what we are going to do. So, for a particular batch, we have planned for 1.5 hours, basically 1 hour 30 minutes. In 1 hour, we are going to cover the concept with the practical examples, means from my side, I'm going to execute the program as well, because this is the technical session. And in last 30 minutes, we are going to have an assessment test. That assessment test is based on basically whatever the concepts I'm going to cover during the first 1 hour. So that test is going to get started from 9:30 to 10 o'clock for specifically this batch. And regarding the attendance, in between the 1 hour, at any time, I will tell you that now the attendance is visible to you on your classroom. So you can go to your classroom and you can mark your attendance over there. And after that, because for attendance, there is a specific time period is given. So within that particular time period, you all have to mark your attendance so that there will be no problem regarding the attendance. So before starting, I would like to talk to any one of you. So right now I will pick randomly anyone. So already I had a talk with the Amog. So now I would like to talk to anyone from the list. Okay. So there is a one girl from list, that is Anaga Nagarare. Hello, Anaga, I'm audible to you. You can unmute your audio and answer the question. Hello, Anaga Nagarare, I'm audible to you. Okay, Aditi Nikosa is there. Hello, Aditi, I'm audible to you.
Yes, sir.
Whatever the things instruction has given to you, all are clear?
Yes, sir. All are clear.
Okay. Thank you. So let's start with the session. So as you all know that we are going to start the technical session on a C. So before starting the session, I would like to ask you here the two simple questions. That is, the one test is there. We are going to start with the simple test. For that particular test, you have to respond in your chat box. So is my screen is visible to you? Okay, so anyone can unmute their audio and respond to me. Anyone, randomly.
Yes, sir.
So screen पे आपको क्या दिख रहा है? Hello.
Command prompt.
हाँ, command prompt, good. तो सबसे पहला question ये है कि we are going to start the technical session in a C. So what I want to ask to all of you is that कि I'm going to run one program. I'm going to run a program. That program name is test program. So all of you have to guess the what is the purpose of this particular program. So right now the program running one C program. I have coded a C program, and this is test is executable file, and this particular blank screen is coming in front of you and cursor is blinking to all of you. So just guess what is the purpose of this program. You can respond to the chat box, because this session we are going to conduct in an interactive way. So I would like to take the answers from your side. In a chat box, you can respond. What is the purpose of this program? No one? Okay, we are getting the responses. First is for input. Okay, so we have to give some kind of input. So I would like to ask the one more question again. What kind of input we have to give? We have to, whether we have to give number, we have to give the string, or we have to give something else. Program is waiting for user input. So what kind of input it is expecting? Input can be alphanumeric. Oh, very good answer. Alphanumeric means you are going to cover the both, means good, alphanumeric. So if I'm going to enter here 4 and 5, for example, I have entered the 4 and 5. I don't know how many input its particular program is expecting. So I just entered the 4 and 5, and then I'm going to enter. So as you can see on a screen, it's returning me 9. So what is your conclusion from this particular output? You can respond in the chat box. Good, addition. So when we started the program, no one is knowing about that this program is intended for addition of 2 numbers. Hopefully my screen is properly visible to you, and the command prompt is also visible to you properly. Font is okay. Can you visualize it? You can respond in chat box. Yes, okay, thank you. So now, in the beginning of the program, no one is able to identify that what is the intended purpose of the program. And then after that, once we try and error, after that, we all are come to the conclusion that, sir, this program is for addition. I will try this program once again, test program, and I will say 6 space 7. Now it's giving me the answer 13. So now we jump to the conclusion that, boss, this program is for addition of 2 numbers. Now, the second thing is that I would like to share one more program with you. So I will go back to the second program. So here also there is a one program is there. That is, the name of the second program is a test2 program. So now once I run the test2 program, so this program is visible to all of you. So I will just minimize it. Okay. So now the test2 program is there. So in a test2 program, if I'm going to press enter, so programs specifically talking to me. That is, program is saying that program for addition, it's mentioning it. And then after that, it asking me that please enter the 2 inputs, that is 2 numbers specifically. So this idea is clear to me that this program is basically intended for addition of 2 numbers. So now every time I do not have any kind of confusion in my mind. And after that, what I'm going to do, I will just enter the 2 given numbers and I will get an answer 7. So hopefully you all are thinking that what is the purpose of this thing? So let's start with your first concept that we are about to start. So let's start with our first concept over here. Those who joined late, I am repeating again. I am Ravi Asati. I am your trainer for technical module. So now the basic question is that when we are going to talk about the computers, so when we are going to talk about the computer, the main important question is here is that whenever you are going to deal with the computer, because you all are programmers, because when you are going to deal with the computer, so you are a programmer, but when we are going to talk about our first program, when you are going to talk about the first program, in the first program, we design the program, that is the program that we have designed as a user. The first program that we design is a test, is a as a user. We haven't designed it as a programmer. Why? That I'm going to explain to you now. Now, after that, the second program that we have designed, that particular program, that is a test2 program that we have designed, that particular test2 program we have designed as a programmer. So always when you are programming, when you are preparing for any particular programming, you have to make it clear to yourself that whether you are a programmer or a user, because the first program is a test program. It designed by an user. He is thinking that I'm a programmer also, I'm a user also. So I would like to mention here is that what is the basic difference in between these two things. The basic difference between in these two things are, the first thing is that programmer is not directly going to communicate with the user directly. Programmer is going to communicate with the computer, and the computer, in a computer, the program which is written by a programmer is going to communicate with the user. So what there is a communication in between these three entities. So there are three entities that are there in which the communication is going to get happen. So when we are going to talk about the communication, so first before learning programming, or first before learning about any concept in a C programming, first we have to understand the communication, how actually a particular environment is working. So this is our environment, and we would like to know, we would like to understand the environment. We don't want to just know the environment. You all are aware about this particular environment previously, but right now we are trying to understand this particular environment and how this particular environment is working. So basically, you are not a user, you are a programmer. So once you put your foot into the shoes of programmer, you come to know that I am not directly going to communicate with the user, I am going to communicate with the user with the help of program. So communication is in between the user and program. So our program should communicate properly with a user, so that whenever we design a program, so that that program should be clear to the user. So hopefully till now your concepts are clear. So now I would like to ask the one question to all of you over here, is that who you are, that is, who are you basically? Are you are a programmer or a user? You can respond in a chat box. The slides. So as we all know that we are the programmers. So once we are the programmers, so we know that in a environment there are different kinds of things are available. So the different kinds of things are, first one is a computer, the device which we are going to, on which we are going to program. So it consists of different devices. The first one is the input device, that is keyboard and mouse, and the output device that we are here available is a monitor. So here we are going to use these devices, and there is a one brain of a computer that we call as a CPU, that is central processing unit. In it we have a processor. So the now next concept is that when we are going to talk about the environment, so here we have to understand the two basic things. So as I already explained to you that we have to understand it. So here first we are going to understand the computer. So when I'm going to talk about the computer, so as you all know that the communication should be proper. Means the communication in between the programmer and a computer, and the communication in between the program, that is computer and a user, should be proper. So for an example, if I'm going to start the session, if I'm going to start this particular session with a particular language, I don't know the languages, but I'm going to say that ching chang pong ching cho, something like that, and ching chong chang ching. So these kind of words I'm going to use it. So what I want from your side is that what you understood from these audios, whatever the things I'm telling to you. So ching chang pong ching cho and ching ching. So these are the few words. So can you tell me what is your interpretation of from these words? So someone is saying Mrunal is answering Chinese language, but actually it's not Chinese language. If you actually write it down those words and if you put into the translator, so there is a no meaning, nothing. It's sound like a Chinese, some is Gabriel something something. So means to communication, to have a communication in between the two person, two entities, we need one common medium. As you all aware about the English language or a Hindi language, or I am going to say about English language. जैसे हम इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज बोलते हैं, कभी कभी हिंदी यूज कर लेते हैं, देन आफ्टर दैट वी यूज फ्यू वर्ड्स. सो जब भी हम इस तरह की बात करते हैं, आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज. सो यू ऑल आर अवेयर अबाउट द वन कॉमन मीडियम इन बिटवीन यू एंड मी, सो दैट वॉट एवर आई एम ट्राइंग टू से, वॉट आई एम ट्राइंग टू कम्युनिकेट टू यू, यू आर एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड इट वेरी प्रॉपरली. सो इन अ एनवायरमेंट, व्हेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द कंप्यूटर एंड व्हेन वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट दिस पर्टिकुलर एनवायरमेंट, so what we are expecting is that a communication medium, so that communication medium should be common. But when I'm going to talk about our environment, as you can see on your screen, so there is a difference in between the communication medium. First one is that if I'm going to talk about the programmer know English, the user also know English, but in between that, the middleman, a computer doesn't understand the English. He understand binary language, he understand ones and zeros, he understand in terms of, if I'm going to talk about the electrical signal, he understand the pulses, that is in terms of, because computer run on the electricity. So communication in between these two person is not a common medium. So we need a one medium through which we are going to communicate with a computer. So that is the medium that we are going to use over here. So for to understand the medium, we have to understand the one basic fundamental basic thing in a computer that we are going to talk about, CPU. That is a CPU, that is central processing unit. Because if you are going to understand the CPU, the many things are going to get clear during the programming. So hopefully till now your concepts are clear. So now we are going to move away. So same first fundamental over here is that the CPU is there and central processing is there. So that is basically a hardware. So in the environment in which we are going to work, it consists of a two component. The first component that here is available is the first one is a hardware. Another component is a software, because to control this particular hardware, we are going to require a particular software. So to control this particular hardware, there is a software that is available. So software is basically dependent on hardware, because software is basically hardware specific. So here we have to understand the one first and most important concept over here, because if you understand the hardware, basically a processor, so you will able to understand the pointer. Because I just want to quote here one thing only. If you understand the processor, if you understand it properly, so pointer is just like cutting a piece of a cake for you. Because we all know that many of you having the very difficulties in handling the pointer. Many of you are not able to understand the pointer. That's why our main purpose is to understand the first processor. And then later on, once you understand this basic concept, the many concepts are going to get clear. So I just want to clear here one thing is that today's first session is a basic session in which, although I know that you all are from computer background, so I just want to clear a few things so that whenever I'm going to refer few terminologies, like in my coming sessions, I'm going to always going to refer the terminologies like 16-bit, 32-bit, 64-bit, this kind of processor. This is the address line, this is the data lines. So you will able to understand it. So hopefully till now, I'm clear to you. I just want to take one more random sample from here. So Nikita Pal. Hello, Nikita. I'm audible to you?
Yes, sir.
Till now, whatever concept I have explained, is it clear to you?
Yes, sir.
And whatever the things I am presenting on a monitor with the help of this particular platform, is it visible properly?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. So now we can move ahead. So now the next concept is that regarding the processors. So we have to understand the concepts regarding the processor. So first I will clear my board, and then after that I am going to explain it. So the first concept, if anyone doesn't know about 16-bit, 32-bit, it's no problem. We are going to understand it in a very detailed manner. So if I'm going to talk about the processor, the basic job of the processor is to process, because it's having the speed. It's having a particular speed, and with the help of speed, we can perform billion and trillions of calculations within the fraction of second. So when I'm going to talk about the processor, so basically processors are divided into the bits. So when I'm going to talk about a particular processor, so processor is divided into the bits. When the processors are divided into the bits, so basically processor, in a processor, there are two concepts out there. The first one is an address bus, another is a data bus that we have to understand. So when we are going to talk about the address bus or data bus, so I just want to clear one concept over here. For an example, today we are going to invent the one new processor of a computer world, that is a 1-bit processor. So in a processor, there are two things are there. For with the help of data bus. Bus means a lines through which a data is going to get flow, and the address bus are the lines through which we are going to access a particular memory location. Either it may be a RAM or it may be a cache memory. So basically, it's deal with the RAM. So for example, we have a one processor named as a single bit processor. That is, single bit CPU is there. So when I'm going to talk about a single bit CPU is there. So there is only one bit is there. Means one bit means only one address line is there. If only one bit address line is there, so with the help of one bit address line, as you all are aware about byte, that we are going to talk about the byte. So in a byte, there are 8 bits are there. So every byte is going to have a one unique address. So for an example, this is the one byte and it's having the address 0, and there is a one more byte is going to get over there and it is going to have address 1. So what going to happen is that if there is a one bit address bus is there, means a processor of one bit basically. So what going to happen is that maximum the memory that we can attach with this particular one bit is a 2 byte maximum, because this particular address bus can generate only 2 addresses. The first address is a 0, another address is a 1. So these are the only 2 addresses going to generate. If it is going to generate the 0 address, we can able to fetch the data inside the 0 byte, and if we are going to generate 1, so we are able to access the 1 byte. So hopefully till now the things are clear to you. So I will switch back to again, as this is my first session with all of you. So I am going to take random. So Priyanka Harne, hello Priyanka, I am audible to you?
Yes sir.
Till now whatever the concepts I have explained, is it clear to you?
Yes sir.
Is it one bit processor clear to you?
Yes sir. Yes.
So for an example, if we have a 2-bit processor, so how many address 2-bit processor can generate?
4 addresses.
Good, very good. So that is the answer we are expected. So how much, means if 2-bit processor is there, so maximum we can generate a 4 different addresses. Clear? So if 4 different addresses we are going to generate, so maximum 4 bytes we can attach over here. So now the thing that now what I want to tell you here is that basically we want to go back to our environment. In the environment, I want to talk about the processor. So we have a 2 processor. That is, the first one is a 16-bit processor and another is a 32-bit processor. So we are going to take an example of 16-bit processor. So basically we are going to talk about the Turbo C environment. So Turbo C is basically a compiler of a Borland Corporation, and it is designed during the 80s and 90s. So during that particular period, the kind of processor is available is a 8086, and then after that 8018x186 and 286. So these are from the Motorola family, the processor available. Basically, when we will talk about the 8086, you all are aware about 8086 microprocessor. It's having the 20 bytes of address bus and 20 bits of address bus and 16 bits of data bus. So if I want to know that, okay, 8086 is of 20 bits of address bus, so if I'm going to talk about, I want to know that how much RAM we can connect over here. So I just want to go here with the calculator, and we'll go to the calculators and we try to understand. So now calculator is visible to all of you. So for an example, if we have a 20 bits of address space, so x is for 20, so that's why we are going to use 2 is for 20. So these many bytes we can attach to that particular processor. So I want to convert it. So initially I will divide this particular number of bytes with the help of 1024. So whatever the answer is going to get come in terms of KB. So these many KBs we can attach. And again, if I am going to design with the divide with the 1024, so we can, sorry, I have divided it. So sorry, I will go back again. 2 is for 20, and these many bytes we can attach. And first we have to divide with the 1024. So 1024k is there, and the same answer we are going to divide by 1024. So the answer is 1, means 1 MB of maximum wave memory we can attach over here. Now the question here is that if you are going to have a 20-bit address, so address of all the, note down the first important factor over here is that if I'm going to have a 16-bit microprocessor, so if it is having the 20 bits address line, so all the addresses is of same, means from the first byte to the last byte, whatever the bytes we are able to attach, all the bytes are going to have a same bits of address. अगर वो एक बिट का होगा तो एक बिट का होगा, और 10 बिट का सभी का एड्रेस होगा तो सभी के सभी बाइट्स के जो एड्रेसेस होंगे वो 10 बिट्स के ही होंगे. ऐसा नहीं होगा कि फर्स्ट बाइट का एड्रेस 1 है और फिर 10th बाइट का एड्रेस 10 है और देन 1000 बाइट्स का एड्रेस 1000 अवेलेबल है. सो होपफुली द थिंग्स आर क्लियर टू यू राइट नाउ. सो नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू मूव अहेड इन एन एनवायरमेंट वी हैव अंडरस्टूड अबाउट द प्रोसेसर. दैट इज द वन थिंग दैट वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड बिकॉज द हाउ द प्रोसेसर बिहेव दैट वी वॉन्ट टू नो. So now, here, to communicate with the computer, we are going to require one language, and that language we are going to use is a C language that we are going to use over here. So with the help of C language, whatever the instructions we will pass through the C language, it is going to get converted with the help of IDE, that is called as an integrated development environment. And there are basically, because of the different types of hardware, because processor is different type, so that's why if your hardware is of 16-bit, that is processor is of 16-bit, so we can use the 16-bit software to code programming, that is the Turbo C, Borland Corporation, or we have a 32-bit, so that is we can use the Dev C++ or a Codeblock. So hopefully you are clear with it. So in an environment we try to understood the two things. That is the first one is a hardware, another is a software. So whenever I refer to the IDE, basically 16-bit IDE is Turbo C and 32-bit IDE is a code block. So don't worry, I will explain you what is basically difference is there in between the 16-bit IDE and a 32-bit IDE. So now I would like to take a break of a minute here, because if you understood, we all are programmers, that is that one point we have to clear. The second point is that we all know that computer talks in a binary, so that to communicate with the computer we need one language, that is C language that we are going to use. So these two concepts are clear. We are clear with the hardware, because every hardware is of different bits, 16-bit, 32-bit, 64-bit. If I will talk about the operating system also, operating system basically based on the, that is 16-bit, 32-bit and 64-bit. So C basically meant or designed to communicate with the computer so that we can perform the programming. We can design the program, and with the help of program, we can process the data very quickly. So I would like to take you back to the days of development of a C, when the C language actually is developed in the AT&T Bell Laboratory. And the father of C language is Dennis Ritchie. He started development of a C language in AT&T Bell Laboratory in 1960, basically. And he has taken the reference from different languages, which was available during those days, ALGOL, BCPL, different languages are there. And by working out continuously 12 years, I just want to quote here one thing. After continuously researching on these languages, finally, Dennis Ritchie sir has able to design the language called as a C, and that introduced in the year of 1972. So he introduced this traditional C language in year 1972. And once he introduced the language in year 1972, after that, in 1978, here initially at 1972, Dennis Ritchie is the only one person who was developing the C language. But during the period after the 1972, one more person is joined in AT&T Bell Laboratory, that is the Kernicom. So Kernicom has its own programming style. So Kernicom has designed, had made some kind of modification in C language. And after that, they both released one more version of C in 1978, that is the Kernicom Ritchie style. So There are the traditional C is there, which was originally developed in Unix environment, and the next version of a C, that is after the Kernicom reaches or join the AT&T Bell Laboratory, they design one new style of programming writing, because there are multiple style of programming writing is there. So another style of programming writing is the Kernicom Ricci style. So that is another Kernicom Ricci style. After that, ANSI, American Nation of Standard Institute, that is basically a standardization institute. So C was the very robust and very good language. So during that particular period, C bahut zyada famous ho gayi. So after that, National Standard Institute standardize the language, and once they standardize the language, as you know that why we need standards, because everyone know that if you need a standard, no? So when we have a 3-pin plug, so we can buy that 3-pin plug of any particular company, although we have a 3-pin of different company and plug is of different company, because in between those three dots, in between the three dots, the standardization is there. So that is the basic purpose of standardization, so that everyone is going to follow those particular standard. So here ANSI's came into an existence. So many compiler design companies have designed their compiler with the help of standard, that is ANSI standard compilers are available. And after that, in that is ANSI is a national body, and after that ISO is an international body who given the new standard in 1990, and they have also recognized the same standard. So in a basically in a NCC standard, there are 32 keywords are there. After that, recently, this is the most important part. So recently, again, the international standard ISO body has sit together and they finalized the. They decided that after these many years of development, they identified that there should be few more keywords should be added, because we all know that in a C++ there is a inline function is there. When we going to talk about complex and imaginary equations, we required that thing. Bool means what? Either the value is true or false. So that is the requirements are there. There is one more keyword is the heuristic. So you all are aware about the C++ language. So 5 more keywords is added in a C99. Standard. So basically, if I'm going to talk about here, so see if anyone is going to ask you, how many standards are there. So basically, any compiler who is going to come, they all are going to have these many standard. Means you can choose an compiler, and in compiler you can make and setting that okay, I want to do the programming in Kernicom Ricci style. I want to do the programming in the NCC style. Or I want to do the programming basically in a C99 style. So hopefully till now the things are clear to you. So I just want to take a small feedback over here. So now here I'm back. So now you can see that anyone can answer me. Anyone from you can answer me. Is it my desktop is visible to you?
Yes, sir.
So now we are going to move ahead. Whatever the concept I have explained till now, I'm going to explain. The first I want to go with the first compiler, that is the during the 1972. We all are having. You all are aware about this compiler. Anyone answer me? Is this compiler visible to you? Anyone, audio. Can you tell me your name?
Mrunal, sir.
हाँ मृणाल, आपको टर्बो सी का कंपाइलर दिख रहा है?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So you all are aware about the 16-bit compiler is there. So we already calculated that कि अगर 20 bits का अगर address bus होगा तो maximum जो होगा वो 1 MB हम अटैच कर सकते हैं. तो सबसे पहले मैंने बात की थी कि बेसिकली कंपाइलर डिजाइन होते हैं, कंपाइलर इज मीन फॉर डिजाइन फॉर specifically hardware purpose. So here we are going to put a compiler, and then after that there is a code generation, and the advanced code generation is there. So here you can observe on a screen that specifically this compiler is made for a particular hardware, that is 8088 and 8086 and 80186 and 80286. So you can make these kind of tuning to your compiler, and you can design the specific instruction set and specifically program which are meant for a specific hardware. So the first thing is that this is the thing that I want to introduce. 8088, currently aapka compiler 8088 mein available hai, and 8086 is the processor in which, and I was talking about the standard. So when I was talking about the standard, so we know that I was talking about that there are different standards are there. Already this compiler is from Borland Corporation. So Borland Corporation have already designed the compiler. So Borland Corporation ka khud ka ek apna writing programming style hoga jo support kar raha hai. Keyword ka ek set hoga jo different companies ko provide karega. It's going to provide, for an example, Borland Corporation is already designed a compiler for a chemical industry. So the companies which are designing a software for chemical industry, they are requiring header files related to the chemical industry, how to read the temperature of a furnace and all that kind of thing. So now this particular company is giving in this compiler to that particular chemical software development firm, and they are basically choosing this option because TurboC is giving. So that by default library they are going to get. If I'm going to talk about NCC, so here I want to talk about here one book that I want to refer throughout the session to all of you, is that there is a one standard book from a Tata McGraw-Hill publication. The name of the book is Programming in NCC, and you can choose any of the edition. Author is E. Balaguru Swami, and you can choose any one of the edition. Right now the 6th or 7th edition is available. So NCC programming, because in NCC it support only 32 keywords, so you can do the programming in NCC style. Unix 5, basically the core development of C is done in the Unix environment, and that's why in Unix environment there is one coding style is there. So in Unix there is a one kind of coding style, and as I explained to you that there is a Kernicom Ricci style. So recognize keyword from the Kernicom Ricci style. So these are the standards are available over here. So hopefully the things are clear to you now. So this is the compiler that we are going to use. So I want to take you to the another compiler. So there is one more compiler is there that we are using for our hands-on programming session. That is a Dev C++ 5.4.2. And if you are going to talk about this particular compiler, so I want to know that basically this particular compiler is of which type. So here if I'm going to talk about this particular compiler, so you can imagine that this is a GCC compiler, and this of 64-bit compiler is there. So now that this compiler is 64-bit, so results, when you put the same program in this compiler, the result will change, because in a due course of time you all will understand what are the differences are there when you put the same program in a 16-bit environment, when you put the program in a 32-bit environment, and when you put the same program in a 64-bit environment, your program behave differently. And why the program behave differently? I just want to quote here one again example, because when aapke jab dost hote hai, jo colleague hota hai, jo aapka roommate hota hai, kabhi kabhi bahut abnormally behave karta hai. So then agar starting mein there is only first day, because you all know me, you don't understand me. So today is all of you having the day of you just know me. Later on the day we execute our training session, you try to understand me as much. So you know that why I'm behaving this way. But today it may possible that many of you are thinking that this guy have some kind of short circuit or something. So okay, no problem. So we'll move ahead. So this is a 64-bit compiler. So that is the basic thing I would like to tell you over here, this compiler is a 64-bit compiler. So now I just want to motivate you a little bit, because we already reached to our 9:15. It may take only 10 to 15 minutes more. So I just want to take you to my command prompt. So till now, concepts are clear. Anyone can answer it. Yes. May I know your name, please? Whomsoever have.
Mrunal, sir.
Okay, Mrunal is answering all the questions. So okay, no problem. So now what we are going to do is that I would like to introduce here very interesting thing over here that I would like to introduce over here. So if I'm going to talk about over here, so for example, this is my screen. There are two interesting things I would like to share with you. I have one fellow inside my computer named as a Chintu. Is my screen is visible to all of you? Mrunal, am I screen visible properly? So I'm going to give one command to my the Chintu. Chintu screen clear. So Mrunal, what do you think? Is Chintu is going to respond?
No, sir.
No, it's not going to respond now. Confirm. No. Keep your audio on, and I'm just going to press enter. Look on the screen. He's responding. Yes, sir. हो गया. दिख रहा है. Visible है ना screen के ऊपर.
Yeah.
Okay. Now the second thing is that I will ask to the there are two components already explained to you. So I would like to take you to the next step. I will give an instruction to the Chintu that Chintu, I want to run Unix compiler. So I am just going to give an instruction to the my fellow. It is designed in C. Hopefully, if you attend the sessions, I will explain each and everything in due course of time during the different sessions to you. How you can able to design these kind of things. So I will give an instruction to the Chintu. Chintu, I want to run Unix compiler. Where in window? In window. So this is the window environment where I want to run, and I have given the instruction to the Chintu. So Chintu will wipe out everything. He's saying. Yes, sir. Ho gaya. Okay. Let's see. You all are about the Unix environment. So there is a one command in Unix environment is there gcc. So I am in a test file. So I just want to make sure that is there any C file is there? Yes. There is a one file name as a hello.c is available. That is our first file that we want to run. So I am just going to say to the Chintu again. So is my buddy in computer who is going to respond. He said that yes sir, ho gaya. Now I want to run the program. I'm going to say that gcc hello.c, because in Unix environment you are going to run the program in the same way, and you are going to say gcc hello.c. so done, program is run. Now he already created hello.exe. Now I want to execute hello.exe. I will just say hello over here, and now the hello world is going to print on your command prompt itself. So now I have given you the flavors of three different compilers. The first one is a Turbo C, which of 16 bit. Then I have given you the flavor of Dev C++, that is of again 64 bit, and there is a third compiler is there, GCC. So even Chintu is very intelligent. If I want to run the C++ file, so I need G++ compiler. So even that G++ compiler also he has installed. So he is very intelligent and is very smart. So hopefully till now the concepts are clear to you. So I would like to proceed further. So here I just want to ask you one thing, move ahead. So now we'll go back to our slide. This is the program that is C, first C program in which on your screen. So when we are going to talk about the C program, so C program is basically divided into the segments. And when we are going to talk about the C program, when the C program is going to divided into the segments, so the in a C program, basically the first thing that we have to understand is that we know that we are working on one environment in which the hardware is available, and that hardware is having the input devices. So on a monitor we want to display something, through keyboard we want to take some kind of input. So for that particular thing, library is available to take an input and output. There are functions are available. So that library we have to include in our program, in an editor, that is hash include str.h. So basically this is stdio.h, that is standard input output library, and .h is a indicator for header files. So if any particular file is having the extension of .h, so it's a header file. Now, so whatever the instructions we are going to give over here, we are going to give the instructions inside the one function called as a main function. So every function is going to have a two different kind of thing. The first thing is the what kind of input he is accepting and what kind of output he is delivering. So there are two kinds of output are there. So I want to clear his one thing. So the third output he can give from this side with the help of instruction. So one input, and here also you can take an input. So basic fundamental that you have to identify that which input you can take from which side. So that we are going to understand. Right now, for time being, you just have to understand that in a one program, we are going to take two different kind of output. We are going to give the two different kind of output, output number one, output number two, then input number one and input number two. So at which time we are going to take the different inputs, that we have to identify. Now, this is the limit, that is opening of a curly braces and closing of it. So this is the boundary inside which we are going to write down our program. So this is our first program and this is a printf function. Inside the double quotes, if I'm going to write anything, hello world, so that is going to print it on monitor. So now it's a time to understand the T1 program. So let's go back to our compiler. So I just want to go back. So the first program is, I want to talk about hello.c. So this is the first program, our hello.c, simple program. Now here we'll go to the compile and run. So with the help of that, whatever you give in between these two double quotes, it is going to get printed on a monitor. Now the second program is related with the environment. So this is the environment. So here we are having the two different environment. So now I want to give a small brief about it, because maine aapko thodi der pehle bola ki aapka ek same program wahi t1.environment.c aapka 64 bit mein different use karega aur 32 bit mein different behave karega. Is it okay? So 16 bit mein 2 answer aana chahiye, 32 bit mein answer kya aana chahiye? 4. Int ka jo size available hai, this program is basically intended or designed to identify that ki whether this particular environment is of which type. So I will first run it, compile and run. So from the output itself you can identify that environment is 16 bit, to answer 2 chahiye tha, but our answer is coming on this environment is a 4, that's why answer is 4. So this environment is a 32 bit environment.